Today was a hard-working day at Selvita. I was about to finish my shift when I found an old sample of malonic acid dissolving DMF sitting in my cabinet. So I decided to stay a little bit longer and set up a Knoevenagel condensation. The Knoevenagel condensation enables the reaction of aldehydes or ketones with active methylene compounds, containing two electron-withdrawing groups, such as malonic esters, acetoacetic esters, acetylacetone, or cyanoacetic acid, in the presence of a weak base, to yield alpha-beta-unsaturated dicarbonyl or related compounds. When the reaction is carried out with carboxylic acids, such as malonic acid, in the presence of pyridine as the solvent, the condensation is followed by a pyridine-induced decarboxylation. The reaction is known as the Doebner modification. According to the suggested mechanism I found, the reaction proceeds via the formation of an iminium ion. The iminium ion then reacts with the enolate form of malonic acid, giving rise to an intermediate that undergoes decarboxylation and beta elimination to deliver the alkene and regenerate piperidine. When piperidine is replaced by beta alanine, the reaction is also known as the Verley modification. To set up the reaction, I follow a procedure outlined in the chemist's cookbook. According to this procedure, in a round bottom flask equipped with a magnetic stir bar and charged with 1 ml of pyridine, I added about 1.2 equivalents of malonic acid dissolved in DMF. To the solution, I added 1 gram of bromobenzaldehyde portion-wise, followed by catalytic amounts of piperidine, about 50 microliters. After the addition of all the reagents was complete, I attached a condenser and lowered the round bottom flask into a preheated oil bath. According to the procedure, the reaction should be complete within 6 hours of stirring at reflux temperature. However, it was already late and my shift was ending soon. So I decided to use a timer to stop the heating after 6 hours. The following day, the reaction mixture was still stirring, but the heating was off. I first took a small aliquot and analyzed it by UPLC to ensure the reaction was complete before quenching. Once I confirmed that all the starting material had been consumed, I quenched the reaction with a 2 molar solution of hydrochloric acid. For some reason, my product did not precipitate immediately after adding the acid, so I decided to stir the mixture in an ice bath at 0C. Eventually, a white precipitate appeared, and the only thing remaining was to collect it by filtration.